Hello there everybody, it's me TechnoChalk here on the FTG server with another Conan, and yes, again, I am mostly naked for you. You lucky people. Now, I am having another look at... Can I get my... Thank you. Wanted to get my UI back up. The tower is going very nicely, albeit a little bit slowly. Let's get down from here, actually. Should probably start this from outside, actually. There's been a couple of little changes I have done. We're doing relatively well, actually, in terms of everything just now. And I have addressed the issue with these overhang bits not being that attractive. So I have put on little corner bits and then used the other... inverted wooden wedge sloped roof. Really trips off the tongue, that. And I have made little enclosure bits around here. So these platforms are nicely enclosed now. They look a lot nicer, I think. And it makes them a fair bit bigger as well, which has afforded me another opportunity. If you see there, see the platform now is pretty much twice the size, really, of what it was, and you can see that I have now started putting the guards on either side of the doorway now, so I can get two guards on each platform. Now, that does mean that we're going to have to go and get more thralls to guard our base, but it means that we will be better protected. So, let's see. This one. Here we go. So, yeah, I can come out here and have a look around, and these guys are stood on the edge. They're very close to being too close to place together. There's a limit to how close you can place thralls. But they do place there, no bother at all. And I have checked that you can get the next one to place here without that one interfering. So that's all very, very good. I got my armorer on the go here. He's been very helpful. I've got my carpenter's bench there. I've been thinking about having proper little signs up, so we've got raw materials will go in there, although steel mace and silk are not raw materials, but yeah, my keeping things tidy's never really been that good, and that's this'll be sort of production stuff, so that's why I've got bricks and stuff in there as well, because we've obviously been getting an awful lot of this stuff together. Right, let's make another few floors and things, I think, whilst we're doing this. So let's head on up here. This is going to be the bedroom area, so I've got my spawn point set there, and we'll have some nice stuff up here, I think. I'm going to get some aesthetic things and do that. But I wanted to show you... Actually, I should have... Let's drop down again. I'm wanting to have this tower come out a bit and be, you know, a bit wider. I might come out two, or I might come out one and then go up some, and then come out another and then go up some. I'll see how I feel. But I've managed to do the corners, much like I've done the corners of the little guard posts. I don't know if you can see because the lighting's not brilliant, but you can see I've used two downward facing wedge slopes and one upward facing one. Because at the first I did just have a normal roof pointing out, but there was a little gap in between it. Now the gap was big enough to be noticeable, but not big enough to take one of those wedge slopes. So I'm going to show you how I went about doing that. If I can get up my stairs. So, as you can see, I've placed these along here like that. That's no bother at all. And there's walls in between, so there's not going to be some sort of funny gap. That's all good. These corners here goes from the square bit out to triangles. And the triangles, as you can see here, this area here being trianglier, goes out to square bits. How nouveau. So, what we'll have here is, let's go fill in those square bits there, and then we'll come along, and this will be the triangles. Actually, I want to put in the upward facing bit first. So that one is attached to the wall below and points up. And then we can take our triangles and fill in there. So they're all good. And then we take our downward facing things. Now, I'm never quite sure because of the overhang which way they're facing, but if you mouse scroll, you can see that's definitely pointing out. So we do it again. That's pointing in. And then we attach that one. Just double check. And that's pointing in as well. So now, if we go and check outside, that should be them done all the way around. And that looks brilliant. I am extremely pleased with how this is starting to look. Or not just starting to look, it is coming together really rather nicely. And I know I keep on saying that, but I am very happy with it. And, oops. I filled in the wrong bit. I filled in the wrong bit. Can you believe it? You must have seen it. Bet you saw it. Somebody out there saw it. And you didn't stop me. Alright, there we go. Right. That's fine. So, let's place these ones down. That's good. Use those ones up. And use those ones up. Any more on me? I've got some walls and stuff. I do have some other stuff, so how many do I need? I need one there. So I need quite a few. That's 9, 10. I need 10 of them. 10 square ones? Can I make 10? No, I can make 7, though. No. I can make 7 of them. Let's get rid of all this stuff. I will see about this stuff as well. So, number 4. Like that. And then, yeah. Now I think this one might actually be 3 tall. I think it needs to be 3 tall. Like that. Fill that one in there. So we're only missing 3. And then I need to get all of these bits. But as you can see, I am still running low on stuff when I'm doing this. And in particular, it's planks. It's wooden planks that I'm running low on all the time just now. And why is that? Because I don't have a thrall for making wooden planks. I don't have a carpenter thrall. And I need one. And the sad thing is, I had one. Just after last episode, Stalker was on, and me and him were having a chat about, and he said that there was a camp just in front of one of his bases. He's got about half a dozen bases. There was one of his camps, and he'd managed to find a carpenter in there. So I went off on an epic quest over to, I think it's here. And so I went all the way around here, up by the pirate ship, and then I came over and down here, and there's rock donkeys and spiders and all sorts of things. And I got him, and then I was on my way back up, and I just come out of actually what was one of Stalker's forward bases, which is around about here, and I got killed. I got swarmed by a heap of beasties, and I got killed. And because I'd been redoing the base, I'd moved my bed, and I spawned back down here. So I made it all the way back up here, and I got to my corpse. The thrall had unfortunately disappeared, but I got to my corpse and all my stuff there, and just as I got to my corpse, I got swarmed by some more hyenas and couldn't get to my armor and stuff in time. And what? Would you not sneak up on me like that? Let's let the archers take care of this guy. Come on. The archers will take care of you for me. Archers, ready? So yeah, I didn't get all hold of my stuff. I'd moved my bed, and I died. And by the time the second time I got back to my base, the second time I got back to my corpse, it had despawned. So I lost all my stuff. So I made it back here. I've made all my stuff again, and I'm back up and running. That was a little while back. So it's not the end of the world, you know. These things have got a habit of happening. Let's get rid of some of that and that. So I need to really get a carpenter, is what I'm saying. I need to have a second go at getting a carpenter. How does that sound to you guys? I see you. I see you running up behind me. So yeah, that's next on my list of things to do, is go and get another carpenter. But there's one last thing that I'm wanting to do before I do that, and that involves, I need to get this floor fixed. I need to get this floor fixed and just make myself go down and down. And there we go. We really are opening up. And let's make some more of these. So I'm going to get the floor up there fixed up a little bit more. And I'm going to get the pit of Yogg. That's what I want to do, is get the pit of Yogg all sorted out. And then we will be, I think, at that point, really ready for another trip over there. An epic quest. So I'll see you in a minute. Well, here we go. Just finished it just now. So the top of this is looking good. And I have made my pit of Yogg. So here it is in all of its massive glory. Clearly I want to get... I want to make this almost directly across from here. And I want to face it this way. Which would be nice. And if I put it like that, maybe? Or maybe I should put it so it's kind of there. I think that would be good like that. I think. Yeah, that looks pretty good there. It's, you know, it's close to round the back, but it's not completely done. Cool. And that does give me, you know, I could put things here, some sort of ornamental thing here, or indeed the stairs up or something like that. Maybe the stairs can, ornamental thing there, and another one here, and the stairs in that bit. I think that could work quite well. Alright, let's have a look and see what this does for us. We can make purified flesh. Flesh that has been richly purified. Alright, and we need to make this Yogg cleaver. So I need 5 branches. Well, I have more than 5 branches on me. Believe it or not, I didn't actually prepare for this beforehand, but it will work out quite well. So we want one of these Yogg cleavers. It's going to take a second to craft that up. And once it does, I'm going to then go and get rid of all the stuff that's on me. Don't need any of that. And we'll see how this translates into coolness. So one Yogg cleaver. All right, let's go downstairs. 2 floors, put my building materials back into this chest, because that seems to be where I'm keeping my building materials at the moment. I can come downstairs. This can go in here. That and that in there. Trying to be relatively tidy, but I'm messing up something chronic here, because I'm noticing that I have a bunch of stuff here that should not be on me at all. Right, let's take all of this, we'll take that just in case, and we should be good. Let's tool up. That goes there. That goes there. Thank you. That and that there, then. It's like power extreme. There we go. Cool. Let's go hunt ourselves some thralls up here. Or rather, let's just hunt us some barbarians, or whatever you want to call them, and we'll chop them up and see about this purified flesh. I'm assuming I need to power that with coal or something. Yep, cool. Alright. Anybody else up here? No, nobody just now. Right. I don't need that. Right, let's chop this up. Ah, unblemished. Now, the human flesh I don't think we can do very much with. But, so we'll just get rid of that. But this unblemished human meat looks like it might be the business. So... you coming over? Or are you just waving? Choppy, choppy, chop, chop. Come on then. This dude's kind of stuck. Yep. And right, we're new. Well, there's loads of them. Really? All the way over here. I need to get my stamina. And I need to go away a little bit. A little bit around here. And heal up a little bit with some of that. Cool. Right. Let's, oh, no. They're despawning too quick. I got some from that. Ouch! These bowmen are ridiculously good now. I mean, I'm pretty good. Ouch. Missed me. Oh, come on. Right. Let's go get this guy now. Right, is that enough for us just now? We've got a little bit. Now let's, I really should have captured him rather than doing that, but never mind. Hides and stuff as well, which is alright. And there we go. Any more? Let's see who's down here in this little bit down here. That's Grok and Nika's place, by the way, in case I hadn't shown it before. Choppy, choppy, choppy. Choppy, choppy. Is that us? Is that us? Anything exciting in here? I'll take that. Take that as well. Really? I think you're even hurting me. There you go. Let's get back over to base and see about putting this stuff into the pit and how we go about getting this unblemished flesh. And we'll see the tower from afar. Oh, it looks good. It looks good. That bit of wall makes it look a bit wonky, but hey-ho. Do and grab some coal from here because we'll need something to power it. I'll do just now. And I'll put you in there. Cool. All the way up to the top. Stuck on something there. Alright. And one bit of yog, and we want to put all of this savory flesh. We don't want that. And I suppose how does that work? Oh, there we go. I don't need to put that in there at all, or do I? That's just crafting, cool. So I don't actually need coal or anything for cooking this stuff up. And we've got purified flesh. Flesh that has been richly purified. It's hallowed and it's consumable. Right, let's have a look and see. And number 8. Now that's put up our hydration as well as our food. And it put up our food by quite a lot. So I think this is the way forward. I'm going to want to get a good amount of this stuff and have it on us, and then we are going to be ready for our trip down the road. Cool. Right, here we are back up at the sort of encampment up here where we got news that there's a carpenter. And I'm hoping the light's going to keep going for me, but time is a-marching on. Seems to be unguarded up here at the moment. Excellent. Things loading in. There's some people and that werewolfy thing down there. Nope. Being rubbish shot today. Cool. Take care of him. And cool. Ooh, a tanner. Ooh, a tanner. Maybe a tanner would be a good idea.
Soon my teeth will taste your throat.
I don't think so, son. Right. Right, this tanner dude, I'm going to get a rope, I'm going to drag this guy back to camp, and yeah, we'll maybe come back for somebody else then. Ooh, that's not too bad at all, like that. Excellent, let's drag him back to camp, And we'll see how we get on with the next bit. Ooh, my throat feels dry. Yeah, that's one thing to note, by the way. I have... it's actually been a few days since the last time I was on. And everything got reset again. There is a big patch because we can now make siege weapons. So clearly there's been some updates as far as getting little warnings about feeling dehydrated. Presumably I'm going to get that about being hungry soon as well. Ooh. Come on then. You're just going to float gently to the ground, are you? Okay. Interesting. Right then, well, I am back on the hunt for some more thralls. I think I need another blacksmith. I fancy another blacksmith, and there's a camp up in this direction that I'm told may well have some blacksmithing action going on, so... Hello, rock donkey. Ow. They do hit quite hard, but... if I'm swift, I can take them out before they do too much damage to me. There we go. Like that. And carry on up this way, I think. Oh, yeah, there's some banners I see in the distance. Ooh, rhino. Not interested in taking on a rhino at this moment. Okay. Right. You... I think I might take care of him. There we go. Now I'll take care of him, and that way I'll be clear to take care of the elephant, because I think... There we go. I think the elephant is probably... going to get in my way. Right. There we go. Cool. Take care of him. And head on up this way. Yeah, this definitely looks pretty cool here. So what's going on up here? These guys here look like tough hombres. Neither one of them... Oops. And you...
Hey.
Oh, come on. Thank you. Right. Ooh. Uh-oh. Run away. Run away. Do not want to take on him. No. Run away. Stalker told me that he took on this guy, but it required a considerable amount of effort. Run away. Okay, come on. Keep running. Keep running. No. Nobody? Nobody running after me now. Ooh. Yeah. A normal rock donkey I can deal with, but not the boss one. Yeah, Stalker said he took on one, but he had, like, several archer thralls and all sorts of shenanigans. And it, yeah, it's a... So, yeah, and it, it took care of most of his thralls. I think he said he had 6 archers on it and himself. So, yeah, I'm not dealing with him. Just not. Right, let's go up this way then. See who we can see. Oh, there's a lot of dead people. Probably because of that dude that we saw. Yeah. Looks like it's largely pointless me being up here. Until things respawn, which is unfortunate. Just have a quick look in here. Oh, I'll take some shellback eggs. Not taking anything else. No point at this point. Ooh, now, these are the flowers. False mandrake. That's the dye flowers you use for purple dye. Didn't realise there was some up here. That's pretty handy. Grab some of that whilst we're here. Take care of this guy. Yep. And, yeah, I don't know whether I should hang around here and wait for respawns, or if I should look in a different area. Well, that was a bit frustrating. I just lost some footage because of a crash, but more frustrating than that, I got back to the Wheel of Pain, the big new one that I've made, so it can take 4 thralls at a time, and as I got up here, I got attacked by a big shaleback thing, and he killed the thrall that I was dragging behind me, so I lost a level 2 archer that I'd picked up, but it's not great. Big deal. It's not like it was a named blacksmith or something like that, so I'm not too bothered. But I thought I would show, just at this lovely time, look how nicely lit that is. But I thought I would show the progress in the tower, so it has done a little bit more. We are looking good here, so that takes us up. It's not quite finished. There's a couple more around the other side there that needs to be done, but obviously I'm waiting on some stuff. But those 3 layers there will take it up to the top of the Pit of Yogg, and then I'll do another floor there, and then we'll get the Set or Mitra Temple, and then we'll do another one. So in total, the temple levels will be in 9 levels tall. So that's the first 3 of them there. And we might go further up. Who knows? But we're really kind of at the point of wrapping up this episode. So things are going pretty well. We do have a Thrall Taskmaster there that I was gifted by Stalker as well. Don't know if I mentioned that earlier on, but he's just a level 1. But he does speed things along. So that Tanner level 2 is just about done in there. We've got our smelter, we've got our blacksmith. Close that up for the evening. I do have a tanner. I've got a level 1 tanner that I've got over here. So she's doing the business. We've got the level 2 carpenter there that I got. I got that one off camera. I thought I'd recorded it, but apparently not, which is a little bit annoying. We've got the armorer that we were gifted by Stalker as well. And I can get various different clothes from him. He must have been taken from the Black Hand's pirate ship, so that's why I can get Black Hand vest, and I can get Zamorian dancer stuff, so that's pretty cool. Everything looking pretty good in here. Lots of lovely lit up area. I love how this looks. This ceiling looks really nice like that. We've got our dancers up here in my bedroom area because, well, who doesn't want dancers in their bedroom? And then this area here with the Pit of Yogg, and the lighting here looks very nice as well. Just with the standing torches around it like that, that's looking pretty good. So that's the stairs up here, and then we'll get the floor for the next level done as well. And it needs to be 3 tall, because I know that the Temple of Mitra is got like a big pole that comes out the back, and that reaches up 2 layers, and it is just slightly more than 2 stories tall. So you can't get, if I only made this 2 tall, then we wouldn't be able to get the floor tile in that was directly above that. So that would be rather frustrating. So yeah, we need to do this. So that is going very nicely here. We've got a good amount of shaped wood and bricks. I need to get some more bricks. This guy, why don't I see anything in here? Did I empty that out completely? Oops. And see how this guy's doing. He is still making 810 iron reinforcements here, and he's made 62 of them already. Cool. He isn't the fastest in the world, though. But hey-ho, you can see it is a lot faster than it would be without him. That's for certain. Oh well. For the moment, though, folks, I shall say cheery bye and have a funs, and hopefully the next time we will get some other cool stuff on the go. I should be nearing the end of getting the tower built by that point, and we'll be playing around with some god stuff, and I think we might see about making some siege weapons as well and see how that goes. But until then, folks, I shall bid you adieu. Bye-bye.